At the Laboratory for Laser Energetics, we do research in nuclear fusion, we do research in high energy density physics, and we do basic research across a variety of conditions that you can only achieve with giant laser systems. As the pandemic started to spread, we recognized that the facility was likely to going to be impacted by the overall COVID impact. And on March 18th, 2020, we suspended operation of the facility. We put the laser into a safe standby state, whereby we could bring it back up again fairly quickly. And we went home to begin working on how we were going to resume operations in a completely different environment.
T-minus 20 seconds.
We're in the Omega 60 control room, where the operators run the laser facility for the principal investigators. Prior to the safe standby, it was a place where everyone came to run their experiment, to make adjustments to their campaigns and understand what is happening on a shot-by-shot basis. Because we're shooting on a 45-minute cycle, a lot of these decisions have to be made real time.
Can we bring it into the final position?
They come from all over the world, from France, England, California, New Mexico, all over the place. We need to be able to interact with these people as if they were here. One of the things that we've built in with the tools of these enhanced communication systems is a system we call Shot Stream. And this pushes our operations environment out to the world and allows the PIs to interact.
Efficiency and the shot tempo is a big part about what makes LLE special. Oftentimes, the effects that we're looking for on these films are exceedingly subtle. We have to work for each individual diagnostic in order to find the optimum resolution and runtime so that we can get the data that is of a high enough quality to make the decision for the upcoming shot, but in the time frame that is necessary for us to configure and then take it without losing any shot time. We've also developed some routines where PIs from remote locations can run imaging processing software right through that remote video stream in order to analyze the position of those targets in order to get them positioned, you know, more accurately than could be done by the human eye.
ShotStream became an important tool. I don't see it going away anytime soon. It's allowed people to collaborate over large distances that normally would have had to have been physically in the building, but it doesn't replace in person, and we're not looking for that at all.
I think that even as we go forward, we'll see the users come back into the facilities, but I also expect on nearly every experiment that we'll see remote collaborators who are going to be operating the same way we're operating today, but in concert with the people that are operating here. We've really pivoted in a way, in my experience here at LLE, that we've never seen anything like it before. And we executed this enormous change to the way that we operate over the period of just a couple of months. And the outcome has been a resounding success.